Have you ever wondered how dancers and gymnasts seem to defy gravity and make it look so effortless and graceful? There are a lot of physics and biomechanics principles that help explain this. We will describe and explain some of them here. Angular momentum. Angular momentum is defined as the amount of angular motion an object possesses. The equation is shown as this. Angular momentum is rotational inertia times angular velocity, or the mass of the object times angular velocity multiplied by the radius squared. The law of conservation of momentum states that in the absence of external torques, the total angular momentum of a given system remains constant. We can use this concept to describe part of the motion during a C jump. If an object has a large angular momentum, it is hard to stop it spinning. Because the turn is done in the air, angular momentum must be generated before leaving the floor. The turn before the jump generates momentum by increasing angular velocity with a relatively small radius with the arms in, which allows the turning jump to be executed more easily. The right leg whipping out and around, increasing the angular velocity and radius, helps gain momentum, then pulls up and in quickly for the jump.
Impulse and momentum. Momentum is defined as a quantity of motion that an object possesses. This is a term that is very important in the world of dance. It is momentum that allows a dancer to perform amazing tricks in the air and allows them to perform multiple tricks in a row. In this video, before the dancer is able to perform her California leap, she fluidly moves to the left twice, before then transferring all of her now gained momentum into the air. She is able to do this due to the principle of conservation of momentum, which states that the total momentum of a system remains constant in time. Now, since she has some external forces acting upon her body, she does lose some of her momentum, but she still has enough to perform the leap. This concept goes hand in hand with impulse. Impulse is force applied over a period of time. This is a concept dancers use to help absorb shock when they land. However, you cannot have a change in impulse without a change in momentum. This occurs when the dancer bends her knees when landing. The bending of the knees allows for more force to be spread out over a period of time, which then allows the dancer to not be injured. Therefore, this is why both impulse and momentum are very important concepts to the world of dance.
Balance and stability.
The stability of an object is defined as its resistance of the object to having equilibrium disturbed. The more stable an object is, the more resistance it has against forces or torques that are acting on it. Something that affects stability is the base of support. Changing the size, shape, or location can make it harder for a dancer to balance, which is the ability to control the current state of equilibrium by the central nervous system. The base of support is the entire area bounded by a perimeter formed by the object's points of contact with the resistive surface that provides a counterforce. So having a bigger base of support means having more stability. So for a dancer, it would be easier for them to balance if they had their feet more spread out like this, which widens their base of support, giving them more stability than if they were to, say, stand on only one foot like this, which gives them less stability, and therefore it becomes much harder for them to balance.
Moment of inertia.
Moment of inertia, otherwise known as rotational inertia, is a quantity in which expresses a body's tendency to resist angular acceleration. It is the sum of the product of mass of each particle with the square of its distance from the axis of rotation. For further explanation, I will discuss the beginner as well as the expert version of the cartwheel. The cartwheel is universally defined as a circular sideways handspring with both arms and legs extended. As for the novice cartwheel, in this video, you can see deficits in his motion almost immediately. His fulcrum arm, or the left arm, is bent. Both knees are bent. He throws his upper body lateral while his lower body drifts forward and his back is hunched over. These movements altogether decrease his radius, which eventually causes a decreased angular velocity. The intermediate or the expert cartwheel, in this video, you can see how there was a slight bend in her knees. She kept her back and arms straight and her hips squared. All of these techniques performed in sequence allows for a bigger radius, and which provides for a more efficient angular velocity.